I'm going home, no more to roam. I'm them just going over Jordan. I'm just going over home.
For nearly 57 years, Bill Monroe called the Grand Ole Opry home. Tonight he finds himself in the ultimate residence as his Opry family celebrates the life of a legend, the father of bluegrass. As a child growing up in Rosine, Kentucky, Bill took up the mandolin. Over the years, he mastered the instrument, creating his own style along the way. In the mid-30s, Bill recorded for the Bluebird label with his brother Charlie. 1938 found Bill on his own, forming a band called the Kentuckians, which he soon renamed the Bluegrass Boys. In the 1940s, he began to add lyrics to the melodies he was perfecting. Many of his songs were autobiographical in nature, like this song about the man who raised him and nurtured his love of music, Uncle Pen. Over the years, Monroe's band served as a school for talented musicians. One graduating class, Chubby Wise, Lester Flatt, and Earl Scruggs, has been called by some the greatest band ever assembled. It was this group of bluegrass boys that defined the emerging style which took its name from the band, bluegrass music. Other graduates include Mack Wiseman, Jimmy Martin, Sonny Osborne, and Kenny Baker. With songs pitched in unusually high keys, mandolin as a lead instrument, and Monroe's high lonesome tenor, Bill developed a sound that would be emulated but never duplicated. Monroe was one of a kind. Most of the past 50 years, Bill lived on his farm near Nashville in a 150-year-old log home, his sanctuary from the road. When country music began to wane in the 60s, he brought his music to the people, leaving the farm for bluegrass festivals worldwide, including his own Bean Blossom Festival.
Good morning, Captain. Good morning, Chime. Do you need another mule skinner out on your new mud line?
Mule Skinner Blues was the first song Bill ever sang on the Grand Ole Opry, October 28, 1939. He got three encores that night, a harbinger of the success to come. Throughout the years, Bill's music would be recorded by everyone from Patsy Cline to Elvis Presley, who actually apologized for changing the arrangement of Blue Moon of Kentucky. Bill subsequently recorded the same arrangement.
I say, the moon of Kentucky, keep on shining.
Today, artists continue to perform the songs of William Smith Monroe, bringing his music to yet another generation of country music fans.
In that beautiful Kentucky,
the Country Music Hall of Fame, Songwriters Hall of Fame, and Bluegrass Hall of Fame, Bill Monroe managed to maintain the integrity of his music, despite changing musical trends. The father of bluegrass has left his children, in his own words, a legacy of music that matters. His job on earth is done. Bill Monroe is coming home.
I'm coming home. For my soul,
for my soul has been set free, has been set free.
All my life,
all my life,
I've been a sinner.
I've been a sinner.
Lord, let the gates
swing wide for me.
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 Wow. A couple of people that were influenced tremendously by Bill Monroe, his music and his lifestyle, Ricky Skaggs and Vince Gill, join me here tonight.
Bill.
Ricky, I understand that you visited with Bill not long before he passed away and that you made him a promise concerning the future of bluegrass music.
Yeah, we talked a lot about music and talked a lot about things over the years, you know, that I knew him and got to be associated with him and considered him friend, not just a mentor, someone that I learned from, but I've always felt like that he might have felt like, you know, that you know, he didn't know what the future of the music was going to be, you know, and you know, the best I could do was just tell him that I was going to play it as long as I lived. I mean, that's what else can I play? I mean, you know, that's the music I grew up on. You know, even in my country music, there's always that foundations of bluegrass there. Mm-hmm. And we love playing bluegrass, and we play a lot of festivals through the year. And I just promised him, look, as long as I live, I promise you, I'm always going to play bluegrass music. And, you know, don't worry about it, you know. There's lots of us out here that love the music, and I think the music's really in better shape right now maybe than it's ever been. I think it can go farther maybe than it's ever gone.
I sat next to your wife, Sharon, at the memorial service, uh-huh. which I want to talk about in greater detail in a minute. But when you and Vince and Marty Stewart and Stuart Duncan and Roy Husky Jr. were up there playing at the very end, right. Sharon turned to me and she said, that's his seed. That's what he planted,
yeah.
and this is what has grown. Vince, I understand that the other night, Monday night, when he died, you were here at the Opry House doing a show, mm-hmm. and you did a song with the mandolin, with the mandolin. Tell me about that.
Yeah, because, well, we played this benefit for Belmont University, and it was full of a lot of pop stars, Michael McDonald, Christopher Cross, Amy Grant, and I think Trish Yearwood was there, but I was the only one that, I told them that I was the only Opry member, and that's the only way they could get the building that night. So they had one Opry guy, but it was the day he died, and it felt very odd to me to be out there and hearing all these pop hits on stage at the Opry House, you know. So I took my mandolin out there, and I played Go Rest High on the mandolin, and just so that a mandolin got played on the day of his death in that circle, that was you know,
important.
I felt it was really important,
wow.
you know, and it was a pretty special moment. I'll never forget it. And then I sang High Lonesome Sound too. I couldn't have written that song without that inspiration. It's amazing, you know. I love his music, but I don't think a lot of people realize songwriting wise what a legacy he'll leave on the music, because, yeah. I mean, it's unbelievable. I can guarantee you that I know more of his songs than any other writer, you know, it's pretty amazing. And then being a writer myself, you know, that to me is really a legacy.
We're going to talk about the writing, we're going to talk about the music, we're going to talk about the style on the mandolin, and we're going to come and go in and out of our commercial breaks tonight with little snippets of music and conversation with the legendary Bill Monroe as we pay tribute to him tonight here on Opry Backstage. Stay with us.
I have played for the last four presidents. Now that is something to be proud of.
When I got rid of my gray hair, I wanted a natural look, so I didn't take any chances. I used the sure thing for a natural look called Just for Men.
Apply Just for Men, and in 5 minutes, rinse. It's specially timed to blend away gray, bring back your natural look, and condition hair.
It's a sure thing.
Just for Men, the sure thing for a natural look. And now try Just for Men Color Gel for the hard-to-color hair of mustaches and beards. Brush in, rinse out. Just 5 minutes.
Dear Robert, it was great talking to you. You know I've had trouble sleeping lately, so I went out, like you said, and got Unisom. I don't like the idea of taking something, but even the pharmacist said Unisom's not habit-forming, so not to worry. Anyway, I wanted to tell you I got
a wonderful night's sleep. The best in weeks. And I feel lucky to have a son like you. Love, Mom.
The Pontiac Firebird waits. 305 horsepower comes to life. Ram air induction turns air into fuel in a rush. Firebird, you're ready to fly.
You know know what dirty pots and pans call for. But what about dirty glasses? Dishes? Silverware? Introducing the new SOS Scrubber Sponge. With a new shape for hard-to-clean places. A thicker, long-lasting sponge side. And an SOS Tough Scrubber side. The new SOS Scrubber Sponge. Now every kind of mess calls for SOS.
Even as we mourn the death of the legendary Bill Monroe, we celebrate his life. Ricky Skaggs and Vince Gill join me. You've got the mandolin now. Is that one of Bill's mandolins?
No, I wish. no, this is one that actually I let him keep this for about 3 or 4 months and play it when he was in the hospital. And he was having some work done on one of his mandolins, so he kept this one for quite a while. He really liked this one a lot.
What's the difference in his style, the way that he played? Of course, he had that driving kind of a sound.
Well, I think in the early days, people you know might have played a solo like this, like a kickoff. You know, and Bill would have played. There was just an aggression that he had, you know, that was just, he was strong, you know, and he would push in, you know, and draw out of people, you know, in a way that not very many, you know, musicians could do.
Watch the monitor over here. I think we've got a little clip of the Rawhide song.
Oh,
coming up
wow.
Here.
Yeah, he nailed that one. Yeah, look, Ma, no hands. Yeah.
I love that. I can understand Ricky Skaggs from Kentucky being into the bluegrass. Vince Gill from Oklahoma. Now, if you said that you were influenced by Bob Wills or somebody, I could understand it better. How did you get so hooked on Bill Monroe
and
bluegrass?
I kind of, you know, discovered it secondhand, the way most people really do discover music. Ricky was lucky enough to discover it firsthand when he was 5 years old and met Bill and played some music with him when he was a little kid. I had to find something and go say, well, now, okay, that guy plays it, but where did he learn it? You know, mm-hmm. So you go back, you know, you almost miss a generation, and that was almost the case with Bill, except that I started playing some bluegrass when I was about 16 or 17 with Bobby Clark, who plays on the Opry all the time with Mike Snyder. He's a great musician, great mandolin player, and I kind of taught him a little bit about Led Zeppelin, and he taught me a little bit about Phil Monroe, you know, and I think I learned an awful lot more about Bill Monroe than I ever did about Led Zeppelin.
Even at the memorial service, when you sang Go Rest High on That Mountain, it had a little bluegrass tinge to it.
Song, it's a bluegrass song, you know. I mean, we made a record that really didn't do justice to bluegrass, but we just tried to make a really unique record with that song. But that song would be just like any other old bluegrass kind of hymn, you know, and the harmony structure and the way it was done. I learned it all from bluegrass, you know, and I found a way to implement some of that. And
I think bluegrass is a feeling, and I think that's really what Vince is saying. You know, he picked up on the feeling of the music and wrote it, you know, around his style, which to me, Bill really appreciated that kind of stuff. You know, I mean, he saw that as seedlings, you know, growing, you know, going out from his music, and he didn't mind. He appreciated other people's styles, you know, that complemented what he did.
The music and the legacy of Bill Monroe. And we'll be back after this. Stay with us.
Hey, the Econo Lodge Senior Room has just what older travelers want. Brighter lighting. Look, still soft and beautiful. Bigger numbers on the phone and TV remote. Time for fly fishing. And an in-room coffee maker.
Spend a night, not a fortune, at Econo Lodge. Call 1-800-55-ECONO and you can save 30%.
You drink about, just drink that. And you'd be surprised. Your eyes, you know, begin to...
I have now been off the Nicotrol patch for exactly 1 month. Using the Nicotrol patch, there was only the one dosage. And that made it very simple to use. You didn't have to worry about different phases and different steps that you had to go through.
New Nicotrol, a whole new and simple way to help you quit. Only Nicotrol has a 6-week program, not 10 weeks like the other patch or 12 weeks like the gum.
I didn't stop. I've quit. And to stop is momentarily. To quit is for good. And that's what I've done.
6 weeks, one step. Take control with Nicotrol.
I want to show you some scenes from my new show. Now, the first...
What happened?
Now, Shelly, by all means, if you meet a female turtle, make sure you keep your shell on for protection.
Having a man in the house all day is like having a piano in the kitchen. It's beautiful. It is in the way.
Listen, you're going too fast. I gotta have a chance to set this up.
Cosby premiering this fall on CBS.
Now.
And cut.
Tonight, when it's time to call your kids to the dinner table, why not let the biscuits call them for you? Bisquick. Make the most of it.
Some people clean their dentures in the daytime. But if you soak at night, get new Polident Overnight. Its unique enzyme formula cleans and whitens better than daytime soaks. New Polident Overnight. Next to fast-acting 5-minute Polident.
As I sit here alone in the room, I see your smiling face. And
oh, nobody could sing it like the high lonesome sound of Bill Monroe. I'm here with Ricky Skaggs and Vince Gill on Opry Backstage as we discuss the life and the music and the times of the legendary Bill Monroe. How did you get him in that video of Country Boy? We saw a little bit of him dancing there.
Well, you know, I just told him that we were going to be doing a video in New York, and I told him where it was going to be and kind of what we were going to be doing, you know. And I told him, I said, you know, I wanted him to play the part of my Uncle Penn from Tennessee that comes to New York, you know, and choose me out, you know. And he said, well, I can really do that, you know. And I said, yeah. So we just, you know, we worked it out. And he said, well, I'll help you and you come help me. So I went to Bean Blossom, traded out one of those Bean Blossom dates, you know, with him. So it was just such a fun time.
Vince, do you remember meeting Bill for the first time?
I don't. I think I was probably about 17 playing a festival down in Oklahoma. I think it was Hugo, Oklahoma. It's the first time I ever heard him play and sing live, and I probably met him at that festival. But
I was told, and I've observed this, and was told, have been told by people who were even closer to him than I was, he mellowed a lot in his later years, didn't he? I mean, wasn't there a time that he wouldn't have gotten out there and done that little buck dance and all that kind of stuff?
No, probably not. I mean, he and Charlie started as a dance team back in the late 20s, early 30s,
in Chicago.
You know, in Chicago. So he knew how to dance and loved to dance, you know. But as far as maybe being in someone else's video or doing something like that, maybe he wouldn't have been as open to do something like that. But, you know, age can mellow people, and I mean, I think love is what did as much as anything. I really got to say that I would just keep pushing into him. The Whites kept pushing into him, and different ones that really cared about him. I mean, if you want to bring somebody out, you got to be willing to get snarled at and bit and all kind of stuff like that. You know, to call him a bucking horse, you got to get thrown a bunch of times, you know. And, you know, Bill was just one of those kind of people that was kind of hard. But I really think that much of that he was misunderstood, because I think he was a real shy person.
He was, you know? And I think the more that his music was accepted, yeah, the mellower he became.
Yeah.
I know you guys have got to get backstage.
Yeah.
I know you're going to do some Bill Monroe music on Opry Live. I can't wait to hear it. Thank you for stopping by backstage. You've
Thank
added
you.
So much to this. Vince Gill and Ricky Skaggs. We're going to take a little look here. We're talking about Uncle Penn. Here's a little bit of Uncle Penn from the great Bill Monroe. And when we come back, a couple of the current bluegrass boys will visit us. Stay with us.
We come from far away, and it ain't so nice to break a day. When you come real hard, do-si-do, you knew Uncle Penn was ready to come. Hey, it ain't good about sundown, how the hill is above the town. Play the fiddle on a hound of rain, you can hear it talk, you can hear it sing. Called Soldier Joy, and when he come Boston boy, the greatest of all, what Jenny Lind, and me, that's where fiddling began. Ring and about sundown, how the hill and above the town, Uncle Penn played the fiddle, Lord, how the rain, you'd hear it talk, you'd hear it sing.
He was one of a kind, and here's a couple of guys that can attest to that. Tater Tate, who played fiddle with Bill Monroe off and on for a long time, and Dana Cupp, who plays the banjo. Mm-hmm. Tater, you were in the band, and you left, and you came back, and you left again.
I worked with him back in the mid-50s for a good while, and I was gone for a good while, and then 1984, I came back with him.
What kind of a man was he to work for?
Bill Monroe, to me, was a great man to work for. He and I got along great.
Mm-hmm. Danny, you must have really wanted to work for him because you live, I understand, in Michigan?
Yeah.
And you fly down here to be on the Opry?
For 5 years.
Been doing that for... How many frequent flyer miles have you got?
About 480,000.
Why?
I met Bill in 1977 in Bean Blossom, and I was just learning how to play. I was a teenager, and ever since that day I met him, June, I always wanted to be a bluegrass boy. And it took till 1991, but I never stopped wanting to do that, so I just got to know him over the years. And like Tater said, he's been great to work for. He wants his music right. As everybody that knows him knows, he wants you to play it right, but... been real, you know, good fellow to work for.
I asked him one time, Tater, right here on this show, I said, Bill, do you have a law in your band that doesn't allow the guys to smile? And he kind of chuckled, and he said, no, he said, we just take the music seriously. And I guess that was his philosophy.
He concentrates on it, yeah.
And he always had you guys dressing sharp. On the Opry, you always wore the suits and ties.
I don't think we've ever done a show since I've been that we didn't wear the hats and the suits.
Even out at the festivals when the temperature is 110?
There was only one time that I remember, and I don't believe he was with you, we were in Telluride, Colorado for a festival, and they our clothes didn't come in with us, so we did the first show in traveling clothes.
That's but he was a stickler for that.
We played in Canton, Texas, where it was about 105 degrees.
Oh, man.
Suits, everything. He wasn't, and we tried to get him. We said, Bill, can't we maybe at least leave the jackets off? And he said, no, sir, no, sir.
But he was out there dressed the same way.
Absolutely.
Right.
He never did anything.
What are you going to miss the most about Bill Monroe?
Bill Monroe.
I couldn't have asked for a better answer than that. Tater Tate, Dana Cupp from the Bluegrass Boys. Don't think that we've forgotten our Opry birthday trivia question tonight, because we're going to be back with that and lots more when Opry Backstage continues. A special tribute tonight to Bill Monroe. Don't go away.
Hi, I'm Ray Romano, and I got a new show on CBS Fridays called Everybody Loves Raymond. It's a good show. I'm just not so crazy about the title. How would you feel if they named the show Everybody Loves You? Why don't the first year we call it Everybody Doesn't Mind Raymond? And then next year, we'll move it up. Raymond's not so bad. And then in 5 or 6 years, maybe love. Maybe.
Everybody Loves Raymond, premiering this fall on CBS.
How about Everybody Could Take or Leave Raymond?
Got tough heartburn and pain? Nothing else. No caplet, no liquid has Alka-Seltzer's effervescent power, plus the medicine for your worst symptoms. Alka-Seltzer, the best medicine for heartburn and pain.
Sun made raisins. Never slow down.
If you've been watching Backstage lately, you know we're giving away some trips to the Opry's 71st birthday celebration. If you'd like to win and come visit the Opry, watch this and find out how.
It's the Grand Ole Opry Birthday Celebration Contest, and your knowledge of the Grand Ole Opry could win you one of four grand prize trips for two to Nashville, Tennessee, including round-trip airfare on Southwest Airlines, 3 nights and 4 days at the beautiful Opryland Hotel, tickets to Lost Highway at the Ryman Auditorium, dinner at the Wild Horse Saloon, a Grand Ole Opry sightseeing tour of Music City, a round-trip cruise on an Opryland river taxi, tickets to Opryland theme park, plus admission to an Opry star autograph party and reserved seats for the Grand Ole Opry's 71st birthday performance. 71 additional winners will receive a NASCAR Thunder racing jacket. To win, keep watching Grand Ole Opry Backstage now through September 14th to hear a total of 3 Opry trivia questions. Write all 3 answers on one postcard and send it to Grand Ole Opry Birthday Celebration Contest, Post Office Box 148340, Nashville, Tennessee 37214. Postcards must be received by September 25th. 4 grand prize winners will be drawn on the air from the cards with the correct answers. Now here's this week's trivia question.
Question number 3. This man is a native of Newnan, Georgia, and before he became a member of the Grand Ole Opry, he worked in the mailroom at TNN. He was inducted into the Opry in June of 1991 by Randy Travis, and he is the reigning CMA Entertainer of the Year. Who is this Grand Ole Opry star? All right, that's question number three. Now, I do need to remind you that we will repeat questions number one, two, and three next week on Backstage so you can get them all together and send your entry in. And who knows, you might be here with us for the Grand Ole Opry's 71st birthday celebration in October. We'll be looking for you. I want to mention a couple of things here tonight. We've devoted the show, of course, to the music and the legend and the career of Bill Monroe. But we got a couple of special viewers that I want to say a special hello to tonight on Backstage. One is a lady over in North Carolina named Eunice Walter, who's celebrating her 80th birthday today. Eunice, I hope you have had and will continue to have a very happy 80th birthday. And also, Elzina McMurray is here at the Opry tonight from her home up in Virginia. She's been a longtime Opry fan, Opry listener. She's here celebrating her 92nd birthday with us at the Grand Ole Opry. We've had a lot from Ricky Skaggs, from Vince Gill, from the current members of the Bluegrass Boys band. I want to just add a couple of words of my own about the man that we're remembering tonight. The first Grand Ole Opry show that Bill Anderson ever went to see was in Atlanta, Georgia. I was about 12 or 13 years old. The star of that show was Bill Monroe. I've never forgotten the impact that his music had upon me. Even though I'm not in the bluegrass end of the business, bluegrass music is among my favorite music, and it's because of Bill Monroe. The first time I ever came to the Grand Ole Opry, Bill Monroe was on the stage, and I remember how impressed I was at how the band worked the microphone, and they'd move in and out and play those instruments and sing those songs, that high, lonesome sound like nobody else. But mostly, I remember walking off of the Opry stage after a performance, and the curtain would be down, and Mr. Monroe would be coming out, and I'd be going off the stage, and he'd look up at me, and he'd say, "Well, son, you did the best you could do." Which I guess is all any of us can do. Mr. Monroe, we'll miss you. We love you. The Opry will not be the same without you. Good night.
And I want to go down to the River of Jordan and kneel down and put my hand in that water. I'm really looking forward to this. This is going to be the thrill of my life to get to go to the Holy Land.
This form shall rest beneath the sod. I'll drop the cross of self-denial and enter in that home with God. I'm going home to see my mother. I'm going home, no more to roam. I am just going over Jordan. I am just going over
the record with Waylon, TNN, September 25th.
I'm Jason Petty. Who wins your vote in our Hank Williams look-alike contest? See if our audience of judges agree. Friday night on Primetime Country.
Come to the Barbecue Center for the best food in town. Full breakfast menus, fast lunches, leisurely dinners, and curb service, all attended by a friendly staff. Our barbecue is still pick, cooked, and chopped by hand as we did more than 30 years ago. Try our old-fashioned banana splits, the talk of the town. You'll have to see them to believe them. All this and more at prices you can afford at the Barbecue Center, 900 North Main Street, Lexington, participants of the Lexington, North Carolina Barbecue Festival.
The MBNA 500 from Dover on TNN. Brought to you locally by Thomasville Ford. Arby's, it's better out here. And by Yadkin Valley Chevrolet Geo.
It's Saturday night in Nashville, Tennessee, and time for another big half hour of Grand Ole Opry Live. Hi, everybody. I'm Keith Bilbrey. Quite a week here in Nashville with the loss of Bill Monroe, probably one of the most unique entertainers to ever set foot on the Opry stage. We're going to pay tribute to him tonight, and here's Ricky Skaggs.
Welcome to the Grand Ole Opry Live, all you folks at home.
Glad to have y'all with us tonight. This next half hour is going to be dedicated to the great late Bill Monroe. And he's dear to our hearts, and we want to start this show off tonight with something. For years I wondered, what was it about bluegrass music that really drew me to it? Later in years, I got to listen to the words of the songs, and I got to listen to the writing and that kind of stuff, and that really drew me to it, and the harmonies. But when I was just a kid, I realized what really drew me to the music, and it was this instrumental right here, Rawhide. Wonderful show for you. We got lots of great guests. Stay with us. We'll be right back.
Pain relief, and so much more. Also, try Extra Strength Bayer, nothing stronger for everyday pain.
Before introduction, a Moen faucet is tested at least 500,000 times against leaks and drips. so it's hard to find a more reliable faucet, no matter how you look at it. Moen. Buy it for looks. Buy it for life.
Got something different for your sensitive teeth.
Well, you can take it back. My dentist wants me to use Sensodyne.
This is Sensodyne. Sensodyne with baking soda.
No pain. My mouth feels fresh and clean.
Sensodyne with baking soda. All you feel is fresh and clean.
Our Bill Monroe tribute continues. The Larry Stevenson Band coming up. Here's Ricky Skaggs.
Thank you. Appreciate that. Good to be back, and we want to bring out our first guest. These guys are really, really fine, and girl, excuse me, are really, really fine bluegrass entertainers, and they work a lot of bluegrass festivals over the country, and we wanted them to be a part of this celebration of Bill Monroe's music. And they're going to do one of Bill's great tunes. Please welcome Mr. Larry Stevenson and the Larry Stevenson Band.
Thank you, Ricky. Thank you, folks. Thank you all very much. It's great to be here tonight on such an occasion and to honor the great Bill Monroe. And I hope you will enjoy just a small part of what we're going to do. From Union, South Carolina, give Kristen Scott on a five-string banjo a nice hand. From Branford, Florida, on guitar is Bowie Beach. From Cedar Falls, North Carolina, is Matthew Allred. And sitting in with us tonight, my good friend from the great state of Virginia, Ricky Simpkins. Here's one of Bill Monroe's real early tunes, a great song that we have recorded on one of our Webco Pinecastle albums. Here's the Kentucky Waltz.
Kentucky, beneath that beautiful harvest moon, and I was the boy so lucky, but it all, oh, it ended too soon. And as I sit here alone in the moonlight, I can see your smiling face, and I long once more for your embrace and that beautiful Kentucky waltz.
Good job, Larry Stevenson, folks. Great job. Appreciate that. Thank y'all for being here with us tonight. Now we want to bring out somebody real special that stood with Bill and played with him for many, many years. He had a, I don't know if exactly when the name Bluegrass Boys came into being, because they were the Kentuckians for a while, Bill's first band name. And I'm not sure exactly. Now, my friend Eddie Stubbs would know this because he knows even the serial number on Mr. Bill's mandolins, so he knows everything. But as a matter of fact, I want to tell you, next Monday and Tuesday, Eddie let me know that this is the 50th anniversary, next Monday and Tuesday, of the first recordings with Lester Flatt, Earl Scruggs, and Bill Monroe, as a band together, as the Bluegrass Boys, that really started the standard of music that we have come to learn to play as bluegrass music. So it's amazing that all this kind of came within a week or 10 days of each other. But it's a very special time for all of us that love bluegrass. And I just want you to put your hands together and welcome a group of guys that traveled many, many miles with Mr. Bill. And they did everything from drive the bus to fix the bus to get rocks and label them and name them from different states and forget where they got this rock and have to start over. And y'all picked up. Billy Joe Foster said the first time that he went out with y'all, he woke up about 6:30 in the morning and this rooster went, and Bill had found this rooster somewhere through the night, just kind of out wandering around on the road, and he put it underneath the bus to bring it back to the farm. So he was good for picking up stuff on the road, dogs and stuff. He'd bring foxhounds back home. So please welcome the Bluegrass Boys and my friend, Mr. Vince Gill. Would ya?
Monster bloom as the years roll by. For me there'll never be another. Well, I love her till the day I die. See my darling in a gingham dress. She looks so sweet. Oh, how I long for old Kentucky, for my darling, I don't mean. She's my rose of Kentucky. I watched her bloom as the years roll by. For me, there'll never be another. But I'll love her till the day I die. I watched her bloom as the years roll by. For me there'll never be another. Well, I love her till the day I die.
Good job, Vince. Good job, Bluegrass Boys. We're going to have y'all back out just a little bit later on. Well, now, Vince, you're sounding good there, brother.
Thank you, Rick.
Yes, sir. Well, I know you loved Mr. Bill. You loved him as a person, but I know you loved his songwriting and his singing. And one of the
great things that I've always loved about his music is the way it was so simple many times. It was just a mandolin and guitar. And we're going to try to do one here. We're going to try. We had long hours today running over this, didn't we? Luke had a ball game today, so.
I haven't sung this in 15 or 20 years.
Well, you was young then, wasn't you?
I was.
She said she looks good to you there.
I thought that might have been sexual harassment there just for a minute.
Mr. Bill would have said, well, her eyes is awful good, ain't they? This is called The Old Crossroads, but this is one with he and Lester Flatt did together.
Oh, my brother, take this warning. Don't let old Satan hold your hand. You'll be lost in sin forever. You'll never reach the promised land. The old crossroads now is waiting. Which one are you gonna take? One leads down to destruction, the other to the pearly gate. To shun the one goes down below. The old crossroad now is waiting. Which one are you gonna take? One leads down to destruction, and the other to the pearly gate. Jesus, our Savior, will protect you. He'll guide you by the old crossroad. The old crossroad now is waiting. Which one are you gonna take? One leads down to destruction. The other to the pearly.
Thank you, Vince.
Thank you very much, Rick.
Vince Gill. Yeah. Good job, Vince. We'll be right back, folks. Y'all stay with us, all right?
Horsepower. Two airbags. And two easy open tops. The Pontiac Firebird T-top and Firebird convertible. Too cool.
Hey, the Econo Lodge Senior Room has just what older travelers want. Brighter lighting. Look, still soft and beautiful. Bigger numbers on the phone and TV remote. Time for fly fishing. And an in-room coffee maker.
Spend a night, not a fortune, at Econo Lodge. Call 1-800-55-ECONO and you can save 30%.
You drink about, just drink that. And you'd be surprised. Your eyes, you know, begin to...
And our tribute to Bill Monroe continues. Here once again is Ricky Skaggs.
Well, I got to go to the funeral Thursday, Mr. Monroe. We had a really special memorial service for him here at the Ryman Auditorium in Nashville. But then Thursday, they buried him up in Rosine, Kentucky, in his hometown. And it was pretty amazing because the church that they had the service in was the church that this next song is written about, of Bill's true life experience, meeting Jesus as his Savior when he was a young boy. Because I had asked him a few months ago if he remembered what the preacher preached on the night that he got saved and became a Christian. And he said, "No, I don't remember what they preached on, but I remember the song they sung." And the song was called, "What Would You Give in Exchange for Your Soul?" And but this song here, I know that song meant a lot to him because that was the first song that he and his brother Charlie recorded that started his music career. And this song here is about the little church that all this took place at. It's called the Little Community Church.
I was lost in sin so long, with no one to guide my way. My soul was in darkness, had been there for many a day. In that little community churchyard, I heard a gospel song.
I went inside
to kneel and pray.
Pray to my Savior
that he might hear and would accept me. And then I felt
the Holy Spirit.
I knew my soul was saving me. Among my many friends, I can hear them praying for me as the preacher said amen. Was a vision there before me, it was my Savior's face.
I knew that I
was saved by grace.
Oh, I knelt down
and prayed to my Savior
that he might hear
and would accept me. And then I felt
Holy Spirit,
I knew my soul was saving me. In that little community church house, there's where we sing and pray. We pray to our Father to guide us on our way. Through life's long journey, we'll need his helping hand
until we reach
that promised land.
Oh, I knelt down
prayed to my Savior
that he might hear
and would accept me. And then I felt
the Holy Spirit.
I knew my soul
was saving thee.
Thank you, folks. We'll be right back. Y'all stay with us. We got a great finale here coming.
I just feel really good, and I can really give my daughter her birthday present, which is what I promise. So that's really important to me, that I quit smoking.
New Nicotrol, a whole new and simple way to help you quit. Only Nicotrol has a 6-week program, not 10 weeks like the other patch or 12 weeks like the gum.
It could not be harder for anyone else in this world to quit smoking than me. That's how I personally feel.
6 weeks, one step. Take control with Nicotrol.
If you want relief from minor arthritis pain, turn up the heat on arthritis. Just minutes after applying Ultra Strength Bengay, you can actually see the heat. It's the strongest, most advanced Bengay ever, with the heating power of 3 pain relievers. So turn up the heat on arthritis.
We're challenging shoppers to compare their Tilex to X14 mildew stain remover.
The X14 side is brighter. What used to be disgusting looking mildew, you just spray and it's gone.
X14, it's better.
Wonderful tribute to a great man tonight, Mr. Bill Monroe. We're going to miss him a great deal. Here's Ricky Skaggs.
Thank you, folks. Appreciate that. We just got a few minutes here. We want to do one of Bill Monroe's most popular songs, and we're going to have the Bluegrass Boys kick it off, and we're going to have all the Bluegrass Boys here, Vince Gill, Larry Stevenson, and it's going to be a prayerful job right here on Blue Moon of Kentucky. Thank you, Larry Stevenson, and all the Bluegrass Boys. Let's say goodnight with Watermelon on the Vine.